That song that was sung is a song, and it is a call to all of us to be ready for when he returns, to be ready and prepared, amen, for when he comes. And so I want to talk to us from this subject, like it or ready or not, Jesus is coming. All right. I want to talk to you from that subject tonight, like it or not, or ready or not, brother.
Ready or not. Come on.
Coming. Jesus is coming. I began to just think about the way the world is now, the life, the world that we're living in, and what's going on, the chaos, the crazy things that are going on. And of course, we know that the enemy is loose within the land, and we are not supposed to fear these things that are going on. Amen. We're not supposed to fear. We don't have to have fear, because he didn't give us the spirit of fear, but he allows us to be able to be prepared for what it is. He teaches us in the word of God, Jesus does, that in the last days, there are going to be all kinds of things going on. People are going to be lovers of themselves. Mm-hmm. Amen. We know that sons are going to go against their fathers and daughters against mothers, and they're going to be rumors of wars, and you know, there's going to be all this, and this still, he said, is not the end. Mm-hmm. But I still believe that if my great grandmother said it in her time, if my grandmother said it in her time, if my mother said it in her time, if my father said it, and so forth, and we've said it in our present state, that he is soon to come. Mm-hmm. He is soon to come. He is soon to come. So it behooves us to be ready for when he comes. And I would like to take our scripture reading from the book of Matthew, chapter number 25. It's a very familiar passage of scripture that we've all heard before, and we've all looked at before. We've all probably read it. And some of us who are teachers and preachers and some people call them Bible scholars. We've read this and we've taught from this particular text, but the Lord impressed it upon my heart tonight to encourage us with this particular word coming from Matthew, verse number chapter 25. And we're going to begin reading in verse number 1. Uh-huh. It says this, and then we'll go back and read a little bit more. It says this. It says in Matthew chapter 25, verse number 1, it says this. It says, then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto how many virgins? 10 virgins. Likened unto 10 virgins which took their lamps and went forth to meet who? The bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 of them were foolish. They that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, verse number 5 says, that they all slumbered and slept. They all went to sleep. They all got a little tired. And verse 6 says, and at midnight, there was a great cry made, and it said, behold, the bridegroom cometh. Somebody say, he's coming.
He's coming. The
bridegroom is coming. And go ye out and what? Meet him. Then in verse 7, it says this, then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. Verse 8 says, and the foolish said unto the wise. Foolish people always got something to say. He said, the foolish says to the wise, give us your oil, for our lamps are gone out. Mm-hmm. But verse number 9, but the wise answered, saying, not so. Mm-mm, no, sir. Lest there be no or not enough for us and you, but ye go rather to the one that sells and buy it for yourself. Go get your own.
Jesus.
So, and while they went and to buy this, you know, the bridegroom came, and they that were ready went with him into the marriage, and the door was shut. And after verse number 11 says, came, they came also the ones, the other versions, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. Verse mm-hmm. number 12 says, but he answered and said, verily I say unto you,
oh, now.
I don't know you. I don't know who you are. He says, therefore, Jesus says, therefore, watch. Therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour when the Son of Man shall what? Come. Hallelujah. Get right there. Get myself on it. I'm going to try to teach this, y'all. I'm going to try my best to teach this. Because I want to encourage us on tonight. I want to encourage us on the night to be ready. We have to be ready. Amen. So this particular text here, it lets us know, this particular text, if I can get this thing here up, all right. It lets us know that in this text, it is talking about these 10 versions, talking about these versions. And in the Greek word often translates, often translated can mean maiden instead of, you know, what it calls it here, the versions. The Greek word versions can be translated into the word maiden. It also means young woman. And here in this particular context of scripture, Jesus tells a parable, and he begins to talk to the people, and he lets them know, and he talks to his disciples and talks to them because he's talking about the kingdom. He's talking about the kingdom, the kingdom, the kingdom. And then oftentimes, and I would love for us to go back and one day, hopefully, preferably, do a study together on the kingdom, what it is. He says, the kingdom is likened to treasure in the field. The kingdom is likened to certain things. And so, but he uses these parables and gives off seed concerning the kingdom. And so in this particular text, he gives emphasis that indicate that these young women are young ladens. They're young women who are unmarried, young women who are single, young women who don't have we don't know, they don't have children, but they're young women who are, in today's time, they would be bridesmaids inside of a wedding. They're bridesmaids. And so the Bible lets us know that 10 of them are ready. 10 of them are ready to meet the bridegroom. 10 of them are ready to see what it is that they've been longing to see. They're ready for the feast. They're ready for the party. They're ready. And like some of us, or like most of us, and like other believers, all of us are trying to make it to heaven. All Amen. Of us are trying to make it into the kingdom. All of us are trying to get to a place to where we can see Jesus face to face. We can see God. We can sit at his feet. Come on, we can worship at the throne. All of us are trying to get to this place. And the Bible lets us know that 5 of these versions were ready. 5 were not ready. And so Jesus here tells this parable. And as he's telling this parable, we get a sense of ourselves. We get a sense of ourselves because, again, all of us are waiting for his return. All of us are waiting to hear the trumpet sound. We're waiting for him to come back and take us back to the place that he has prepared for us. And what Jesus here, I believe, is teaching here is that he lets us know that heaven or this kingdom is a prepared place for prepared people. Y'all know? It's a place that is prepared for prepared people. This kingdom, this party, this thing that Jesus, that he's talking about here, this bridegroom that's ready to, that's on his way to take the bridesmaid, to take them to the party or to the feast. He has prepared this place. You don't go to a wedding and just pop up at the wedding and ain't nothing prepared. Come on. How silly would it be for you to go to a wedding and there's no decorations? Come on.
Amen. Come on.
There's nothing, nothing there. You ain't got the flowers. You go there and they get to the altar. There's no ring bearer. There's no ring. There's no preacher. Nothing is prepared. In John chapter 14, he says this in John chapter 14, verse number 2 and verse number 3. He says, in my Father's house, God Almighty.
Come on now. Come on.
Mansions. Were not so what? I would not have told you. I would have told you that it wasn't nothing there. He says, but I go to prepare a place for you. The Bible says in verse number 3 in John 14, he says that if I go to prepare a place for you, he says, I will come again unto you and receive you unto myself. Jesus is letting us know, even in the beginning of this text, where it says that there should the kingdom of heaven is likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps and who went forth to meet the bridegroom. There was a prepared place that they were trying to get to. There was a prepared place. And like many of us, and like many of other people that are in the body of Christ, we are invited to this feast. We are welcomed to this feast. I learned that the preacher can invite you to the Lord. But it is Christ, it is God who welcomes you in. Come on, the preacher can invite you into the party, to the feast. But it's Christ that welcomes you in. I can invite you to the party. I can invite you to the party. But it's the one who's having the party who can welcome you. Come on. Yeah. Do y'all get that? Because prepared the place. I didn't work for it. All I did was invite you. Come on. All I did was go out into the hedges and the highways and the byways to invite you to come in. And that's what Word of God tells us to do. So Jesus said, this place that I'm talking about is a prepared place for prepared people. And so we want to talk about just how is it that we are supposed to be prepared? How is it that we are supposed to get in this thing? And how is it that we're supposed to get to the place to where we hear well done, that good and faithful servant. How do we get to this place? One thing that sticks out to me is this, is that, and then you're going to hear me say this word a lot tonight, it is to be prepared. You have to, there has to be preparation. Come on, there has to be preparation in order for you to get to the place where God has for you to get to. Guess what? God has to prepare you. Come on. He has to prepare you. If we look in the scriptures, we'll find out that anytime God began to use somebody, he always prepared them. Come on. Wasn't it Moses that he prepared on the backside of the mountain? Come on. Wasn't it Moses? Wasn't it Jesus himself that he prepared when he was out there in the synagogue, when he was preaching to those that were older than him? He prepared him. It was David that he prepared when he It was David that he prepared when he was out there taking care of the sheep. It was David. It was you who he prepared when he was It was you that he prepared when he was out there in the world living the life that you want to
come on. Come on.
How was he preparing you? Because he was preparing you in the presence of your enemies. That would talk about you, that would lie on you, that would scandalize you, that would leave you behind. The ones that would all manners of evil against you. He prepared you to handle the haters in your life. Come on.
Jesus.
He prepared you for it. I wish I could get about two of y'all just shouting.
Come on. Come on.
That with all of the wisdom that God has, with all of his glory, with everything that he is, I'm glad that he knows how to prepare me. Because to me, I would know where to begin, how to prepare myself. Come on. And that's the
Me neither.
We try to prepare ourselves. Come on. The Bible lets us know that these were 10. There were 10 of these young women. There were 10 of them. And what I like is, let me slow down, because I feel this thing, because I got personal to me, y'all. It got real personal to me now.
That's all right. Come on now.
In the scripture, it says that there were 5 that were wise, and it was 5 that was foolish. Come on. It was five that walked in wisdom, and it was five that walked in foolishness. It was five that were prepared, and five who had their oil and their lamps trimmed. They had oil and their lamps, but the other five only had their lamps. And when I read this here, I'm gonna see if y'all gonna catch this. It says this in verse number. Let me see. I want y'all to read it real quick. I want y'all to read it. It says in verse number of what verse is that in? It says that five of them. Verse number three says that. Verse number two says, and five of them were wise and five were foolish. He says, and the foolish was like this. It said, the foolish, they that were foolish, took their lamps and took no oil. He says this. He says, I want to say it the way he told me. He says, not everybody that's carrying a light has oil. Y'all missed that. Good God Almighty.
It cut out on you. Not everyone that what?
Not everybody who carries a light. Not everybody who has oil or who has a light in their life.
Mm-hmm.
Carries oil. Not everybody.
Jesus.
What am I saying? Because they were ready, but they were unprepared. See, they, that's the difference. They were ready, but they were unprepared. They were ready for the bridegroom to come, but they weren't. They weren't prepared for him to come. It lets us know that not Jesus says in Matthew that not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter in. Come on, isn't that what Jesus said? He says not everybody that cries Jesus, Jesus is Lord, and he's the King of Kings. Not everybody is going to make it in. But who is the ones going to make it in? It says, but he that doeth the will of my Father, it's him. Mm-hmm. Does the will of my Father. That's the one that's going to make it in. In other words, the one that's doing the work, the one that is prepared to go in is the one that's going to make it in. That's the one that's going to make it in. And so not everybody that cries Lord, not everybody that's preaching is going to make it in.
That's right. Come on.
Not everybody that's shouting and dancing in church
is
going to make it in. Not everybody that is a leader in the church is going to make it in. Not everybody that's paying their tithes is going to make it in. Not everybody.
Come on, Cassidy. Come on, Pastor.
Going to make it in. Not everybody.
Who's not casting the demons?
Mm-hmm. Not everybody. Not everybody that's crying, Lord, Lord. Not everybody that's laying hands on sick and people being recovered are going to make it
in. Right. That's right.
Because a lot of people have the light, but they don't have oil. People have light, but they don't have oil. The oil is the anointing. And what these five and what these 10 versions represent is they represent disciples. They represent disciples. And there are two kinds of disciples or two forms of disciples that we see. Five or what? Foolish.
Wise and five of those foolish.
We're wise.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, there are disciples who are prepared and ready and doing work.
Mm-hmm.
Disciples that slumber.
Mm.
The Bible lets us know it here. It lets us know in verse number four, it says, verse four says this. But the wise took their oil and their vessels with their lamps. They were prepared. See the difference. Then verse five says, and while the bridegroom tarried, they all slumbered and slept.
Mm-hmm.
Now the difference between we who are in Christ. Difference between us and they that are in the world outside of Christ. The difference is that we rest in God.
Mm-hmm.
While they that are outside of Christ slumber. Slumber is to sleep lightly.
Mm-hmm.
It means to be in a corporate. It means to be slothful or in a negligent state. It means to lie dormant. Don't do nothing. You just ain't doing nothing. Just ain't ready. And there's no rest for the wicked or for those that are outside of Christ. And so I'm learning here that even though it says here that they all slumbered, and can we keep it real? All of us at one point of time slumbered.
Come on.
All of us slipped up. Come on. It was the disciples themselves that Jesus said, hey, pray with me for a little while. And they went to sleep. And if they're walking with Jesus and going to sleep, come on. We walk in the spirit. So I know some of us are going to sleep. I know some of us. And the Bible lets us know that all of us have what? Come short. Ooh, we've all fallen short to the glory of our Father. We've all come short. We've all slumbered. But aren't you so glad, hallelujah, that we serve a God that Norman Denton doesn't slumber nor sleep. Hallelujah. Every time we need him, we can call on him. Every time, every time. Every time we are in a place to where we need our Father, we can call on him.
Come on now.
Amen.
Nor sleeps.
Mm-hmm.
So it lets us know that these 10 virgins went to sleep. But I believe if we could really look at this thing, the ones that were wise slept in peace. They didn't worry about too much because they were prepared. See, when you're prepared, you don't have to worry. Come on. Jesus gave us this great example of in the midst of your storm. Come on. Wasn't it Jesus that went to sleep on the boat? Yeah, it was Jesus.
Amen.
Was knocked out while everything chaos was going all around.
Yeah.
Are you at peace when chaos is going around and it ain't got? Are you at peace when things aren't going the way that you think they ought to go? Can you say that I'm at peace? I'm at peace, even though it's not going the way that I think that it ought. Even though this situation may be a little scary, it may look a little funny, but I'm at peace because I know that he that is with me is greater than that thing that I'm facing. He's greater than the fact that I don't have enough. He's greater than the fact that I get by myself and I'm feeling lonely. So he's greater than that I don't have all that I want, but he's so much greater to the fact that even though I don't have what I want, he told me that he'll be my shepherd and I shall not want. Why? Because he's greater. He's greater than whatever it is that you might be going through and dealing with. He's greater than all of that. I don't care how crazy this world is. Come on. I don't care how many tricks that the enemy tries to bring up against you, how many lies and how many ungodly emotions that he tries to attach to you. God is greater than all of that. Greater.
Yes, he is.
Greater.
Amen.
He's greater. He's greater than that. He's greater.
Amen.
Greater than that. And I know that he's greater because when I am worried, come on. He gives me peace.
Jesus.
He gives me peace. When I get weak, he is the antidote for every negative thing in your life.
That's good news right there.
Teaching right there.
Let me say that one more time. He is the antidote.
That's it.
Negative thing that the enemy tries to throw at you. Come on.
My prescription.
Come on. And you'll find this out in the word of God.
Because
every negative thing that the enemy even tried to throw at Jesus turned out for the positive. Every time that he tried to come at Jesus, Jesus countered with the word of God. See, you can only counter the enemy if you know what you're talking about. You got to have the word of God. This is preparation. Preparation is me being prepared for whatever comes. Survival instincts. You have to know, and Elder taught about this a couple of weeks ago, talking about the readiness of mind. Whew, your mind got to be ready. Your mind has to be ready for his return, because like it or not, he's coming back.
That's right.
He's coming back. Sister Christine, he's coming back.
Yep.
He's coming back. Whether I get what I want out of this life or not, he's coming back.
That's it.
Amen.
Whether I ever get the bins that I'm gonna get, he's coming back. Come on. Whether I ever get the house, come on. Whether I ever get the wife, he's coming back.
That's it. That's it.
And so we have to be prepared for his return.
That's heavy.
Look, the Bible lets us know is that all of them heard this cry. And we know the Bible talks about Gabriel licking his lips or blowing the trumpet. Come on, the Bible don't talk about him licking his lips, but you know, Christians put that on there. Talking about, yeah, Gabriel licking his lips. He ready to blow that trumpet. Yeah. Blow it until Jesus say, all right, I'm ready.
Yeah.
Huh? But all of them heard the cry when whoever it was said, the bridegroom is coming.
Jesus.
Get ready to be up. And they woke up out of their sleeps. They woke up out of their slothfulness, out of their slothfulness. They woke up out of their state of that trance that the world put them in.
Come on now.
They woke up out of it. Come on. They woke up out of the trance that COVID is after me. Come on. They woke up out of that trance. They woke up out of it and they heard the call.
Jesus.
They heard the call. They wasn't worried about sickness. They wasn't worried about death. They wasn't worried about who was looking. They wasn't worried about who was with them or not. They heard the call.
Right. Yeah.
How do you react to the call? How do you react to the call? How did you react to the call when you heard? Some people heard and ran. Come on, I've been there. I heard the call and I took off and went the other way and didn't.
Jonah.
How many know when you run the wrong way, you're running to something that'll bust your head. Come on. You run the wrong way if you want to.
Yes, God.
A lot of times, the safest thing is not running with the crowd.
Amen.
Come on. You're hearing gunshots and a crowd going that way. You ain't got to go with the crowd. You might want to go not the opposite way, but go the other way because somebody's shooting in the crowd. Come on. See, y'all think about
Jesus.
That. They don't think about that. Now, when they get to shooting, I'm not running with the crowd. They go that way, I'm going that way. Because somebody might get hit in the crowd because there's more people over there. Come on. You know, and the enemy only goes after where he sees people who are trying to get away. He comes after people who are trying to live better, to trying and
come on.
He's coming after people who feel a certain kind of way about life. Come on, he comes after them in those kind of ways. He comes after people who are hanging with the wrong crowd. Come on, he comes after people who aren't ready, who aren't prepared.
And that's right. That's right.
We have to prepare ourselves. Come on,
that's right.
Prepare ourselves. Not just for him to return, but prepare ourselves for where he's taking us. Because I believe it, whether you believe it or not, he has prepared a place for each and every one of us.
Amen.
Here in this earth. Come on, he's prepared a place for all of us. He's prepared something for all of us to do. And it behooves us to listen and hear and take heed to the call that he has on our lives. And so God lets us know here. Let us know here that they all heard the call. They all heard, hey, he's here. The bridegroom is here. And the Bible says that they woke up. They arose. It says all of them arose. And it says in verse number 7, and all the virgins rose. All of them arose. The ones that were ready and prepared and the ones that was just ready. All of them arose. And they and trimmed their lamps. In other words, they took the oil that they had, and because their lamps had dwindled down, because their lamps, the oil that was in the lamp began to burn down. They didn't cut the lamp. You can't afford to cut your lamp off. Let me tell somebody that one more time. You can't afford to cut your lamp off. Come on. You can't afford to cut your light off. You are the light of the world. You got to let it shine.
That's it.
But But the problem is that we cool with just letting it shine, and we don't want to get no oil about us. Come on, you got to get some oil about you. The oil comes about when you fast and when you pray, when you seek God's face, when you turn that plate down, when you turn that woman or turn that man down, when you close
come
it,
on.
Up, when you sanctify and consecrate yourself. When you do that, you get some oil. Come on.
Come on.
It's hurtful when you can't get that one to love on you and all. It's hurtful, but God is pressing you.
Come on.
Pressing you, and he's squeezing you. And whether you know it or not, he's putting oil in your life. He's putting oil in your life. That's why you don't fit in with the crowd. That's why when you ride with the one who ain't on your level, come on, it don't feel right, because it's something God is squeezing out of
come
you.
Come on now.
Please, that stuff that you were used to out of you, that stuff that you brought with you, he wants to squeeze it out of you and put oil in its place. Because truth of the matter is that some of us are so anointed, the devil don't like it. Come on. So anointed, God has so much oil that he wants to pour inside of us, and the enemy is trying everything he can cut you off and to kill you and to clip you on, because as long as you're connected, some oil that can flow in your life, you have to learn to stay connected, stay prepared for what it is God wants to do in your life.
Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
Is that you have to have. God is preparing you for the oil. He's preparing you for what it is that he has to pour into your life. Bible lets us know that they were ready. They heard, and the foolish ones began to talk. And they said this. They said, hey, give us some of your oil. Because our lamps have went out. give us some of your oil.
I earned it.
Not only can you not afford to give your oil away.
Come on.
But the one asking for it can't afford it. Not yours. Your oil is for your lamp. Listen. Jesus is showing us here is that this thing has to be personal.
Jesus.
This preparation that they had to go through is a personal preparation. Come on. It's you being prepared, not to the fact to where you in other words, there comes a time where you have to get it for yourself.
Come on.
You have to go after the oil for yourself, because you have to prepare for yourself. I like this, because it lets us know that it's about a personal faith. Come on. It's about a personal relationship. It's about personal repentance. It's about personal baptism. It's about personal holiness. It's about personal servitude. Because because when it comes down to it, I can't get you into heaven. Come on.
Come on now.
Jesus says it. He says it like this: What profit a man? God Almighty,
Jesus,
the whole wide world, very old soul. What profit?
Jesus,
I can be the light in somebody else's life and not have enough oil to save my own soul. What is it that I have to get? I can bring you to Christ. I can do this for you, and I can do that for you, but turn around and lose everything I got. Come on now.
I myself become a castaway. Come on.
Your house and my house is messed. No. God doesn't want us to be like that. What profit is it to you? If you lose your own soul, if you gain everything.
Wow.
What profit is it?
God.
So he's letting us know here that there comes a time in your life when you stop going off of grandma's prayer. Come on.
That's it. Come on.
There comes a time when you stop going off of daddy laying hands on you and you start laying hands on yourself.
Come on now.
There comes a point in your life to where you stop trying to living off of other people's anointing. Come on, that's what it is. Other people's anointing and stop living off of other people's calling and do what it is that he has called you to do. Come on, do it the best way that you can do it. Guess what? He's already prepared you to do it, but you have to prepare yourself. Tells us that we ought to study to what? Show ourselves.
Show ourselves approved.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You gotta do it for yourself. You want to be the boss. You want to be a millionaire. You want to have your own business. Go after it. Do it. Do it with all of your heart. Come on. Do it with all of your soul. And when you finish doing it, give God glory for it. Because if it had not been for him giving you the strength and preparing you for the call and for the gift.
Already? Come on, somebody.
For the house and for the car, for the husband, for the wife. If it wasn't for him preparing you for it.
Jesus.
I have to get into place to where we're no longer living off of other people's stuff, huh?
Come on, that's good.
We're no longer living
that's good.
Off of other people's stuff. Jesus is letting us know that you have this thing is personal.
That's right. That's right.
Make it into the kingdom off of nobody else. Come on. And so you've got to be ready. Mama can be
ready.
Grandma can be ready. Husband can be ready. The song said there was a husband and a wife laying in the bed. And one woke up and the other was caught up in the rapture. Come on. Now, the song said that the mother was in the mall with her kids. And the mother was raptured up and the kids was left. And it said, what are you going to do when mama's gone and she can't pray for you no more? That
comes
time in your life that we all have to mature.
Help us.
That's right. That's right.
In the natural realm. We have to mature in our finances. Come on. We have to mature in our relationships. We have to mature in our mentalities. Why? Because
we have to mature even in this world.
Jesus.
Satan's devices. So I have to be personal with it. I have to be intentional. I have to look at it from the view that if I don't get it for myself, I'll be left behind. Come on. If I don't get it for myself, nobody else in my family might can make it there, but I've got to make it.
Come on.
Is living this kind of way. I can't help it that my brother's living this kind of lifestyle, but I'm so glad that choose to ready myself. I choose to get my mind right. I choose to get my spirit right. I choose to get my heart right. I choose to get my life right. I choose not to suffer in the things of the world, but I'll suffer with Christ, knowing that in the meantime and later on in it, I'm going to reign with him because it don't matter what nobody else thinks because I'm ready for when it comes. Come on. I want to say, is there anybody ready? Is there anybody ready?
Amen.
Amen. Why? Because he's prepared the place for me. Come on. I'm ready for that place. Come on. That he has for me. And the problem is that some of us ain't ready. We talk like we're ready. Come on. It says that they love
we act like we're ready. Come on now.
From me. Come on. Your actions ought to show that you're ready. Come on. Your lifestyle ought to show that you're ready. How you talk, your relationship with people on your job, and how you begin to act with people you don't know ought to show that I'm ready.
Yes.
I'm ready.
My Help Lord. Ready.
Come on now.
Let us know here. It says, and they answered him and said, not so. Some of us have been saying yes too long. We've been saying yes to the wrong stuff for too long. We've been giving our stuff that God has given us over to the enemy or to people who don't deserve it.
That's good.
Come on. Yeah.
That's good.
Huh?
That's true. That's true.
That's good.
Some of us have given our time to people who didn't deserve it. We've even lended our ear to people who didn't really didn't want to hear what we had to say, who really didn't, you know, we've lended stuff to people. We've done, you know, they call it the yes man or the yes woman. You know, yes. What you need? Yes, I got it. Yes. But here the scripture says it's okay for you to say no. It's okay. It's okay.
That's right.
No, not tonight. It's okay. No, not this time. No, it's okay. It's okay. No, not this week. No, it's okay. It's okay because you have to learn to treasure what it is that God has placed in your care.
That's right.
Teach.
Yeah. You can't allow everybody to get a portion of what God has given to you. Come on.
That's good.
You can't. Everybody don't deserve that. No. You have to keep a portion for yourself.
That's right.
When you're in a place to where ain't nobody there for you to call on, you got enough.
Come on.
Your spiritual storehouse to where you can prophesy over yourself. Isn't it right? What David said, he encouraged himself. Come on, when the very ones that he helped, the very ones that he prayed for, he fought for, the very ones he was willing to lay down his life for, looked at him and said, man, we're going to fight you. Because
come on.
And not realizing that David lost stuff too.
Yeah.
His family was taken too. But the very men that he fought beside, stood beside, come on, the very people that some of us prayed beside let us down. The very people that some of us did ministry with let us down. But yet,
that's it.
This particular thing here, you have to say, no, not this time. I'm not going to let it bother me.
I'm not going
to put me down. Why? Because I'm waiting and I'm ready and waiting for the bridegroom.
Ooh, I'm waiting and I'm ready. Woo, I heard that.
What it is that God has coming my way.
I'm
ready. I'm waiting. Can I encourage about two or three of y'all to keep waiting?
Come on.
Amen.
Keep waiting. Keep one mouth shake. Cool. Keep waiting. Keep waiting. Because
Jesus. Yes.
He says that they tarried, but he was still on his way. Come on.
Come on now.
Come on. Hey, that's it.
Your oil got a little low, but he was still on his way. Come on.
Yeah.
They had a weak moment, but he was still on his way. Come on. Good God Almighty. They were prepared for what it was.
You better preach, Pastor.
Are you prepared?
You better teach tonight now.
God has coming your way. Are you prepared? Are you prepared?
Are you prepared? Are you prepared? Are you ready?
To open up from the heavens. Are you ready? Are you ready? Come on. God Almighty, I hear you, God. Some of us, we're not even ready for what he's about to pour out into your bank account.
Come on.
Ready for it, but he's going to do it because you was waiting. Come on. He's going to do it because you said, I'm going to wait on the Lord. I'm going to trust in the Lord. Come on. With all of my, I'm gonna lean not to my own understanding. I'm gonna keep on trusting. I'm gonna keep on fasting because
I realize
that something is on the way. Come on,
it's on the way.
Christine, it's all right. You look that you would wait on that chair. It came, didn't it? It was on the way. Come on. Sometimes we might miss it and might miss what God has for us. But that don't mean God won't put a boomerang on that thing and allow it to come back
out.
It don't mean that what it is that we've been praying for and fasting for is in vain and it's not gonna happen. Yeah. He just stole the vision. Tear it. Come on.
Come on. It's still on the way.
The things that you've been praying for. Come on, Daniel. The things that you've been praying for, and it seemed like it's taking a long time. Hey, it's still on the way. All you got to do is keep on waiting. Keep on waiting. And make sure you have your oil ready. Come on. Make sure you have your oil ready. Because when they woke up, got up, it said that they trimmed their lamps. They trimmed it, which means they poured their oil into the lamps. They refilled their lamps. God Almighty, I'm going to tell you something. If you don't have oil to help you refill in the midst of what storm that you might be facing, might be going through, if you don't have that oil to trim in your life, you're going to be like the five foolish and be wanting some help, but help ain't going to be there. Why? Because in this race that we're in, it's not about me winning and beating you, but it's about me finishing the course.
It's personal.
God,
personal.
It's about you being beating me. It ain't about you arriving. It ain't about you having a title. It ain't about you being more anointed than me. No. Can you finish?
Jesus.
These five
fools
could not finish because they didn't have oil. They were just, they had their lights.
That's good, Pastor.
They had their lights. And if you can be honest, woman of God, children of God, we see a lot of people who had great names in the kingdom of God. And all it is now is lights. They just have lights. They don't have no more oil. Come on.
They were ready in the beginning.
because now they were in the spotlight. Now they were ready.
Come on.
They were ready for it. And the oil was flowing. They had their lamp trimmed. And it was stuff in there. It was oil in there. But over a period of time, the oil began to fall.
Come on now.
Burn it down.
Come on.
Help me.
We have to lose it.
They forgot to prepare. For the future. Now listen, the Ten of David is preparing for the future.
You is teaching.
Ten of David is preparing for the future.
Mm.
Listen, we're not going to run out of oil.
Come on.
It is my prayer that whoever God sends and whoever God attaches to us, that we all get oil in our lives that we can take out to the king, take out to the hedges and highways. Come on. Oil in your life that you can be an example on your job to whoever that may be not so pleasing to you.
Have
enough oil and enough light to shine and enough oil to put on them. Come on. They can receive the gift of God. They can receive Jesus into their life.
Amen. That's right. That's right.
Prepared even to do work.
Mm.
While you're waiting. Can you work while you're waiting?
Can you work while you wait? Come on now. Mm. Jesus.
Come on. Come on. That's a whole nother message right there.
It is. Mm. Can you work while you're waiting? God Almighty.
Why are you waiting? My God.
And the thing is that when you begin to wait and you're waiting patiently, like I said earlier, sometimes we want to do it ourselves.
Mm.
We want to go before God. But wait on the call.
That's
when
it.
You hear the call, when you hear the sound, that's when you move. If they never would have heard the voice, they would have still been stagnated.
Amen. My God.
I talk to you about myself. If I never heard the voice of God, I would have still been where I was.
Mm.
If we didn't hear the voice of God, there would be no Ten of David. If we didn't move on
the Come
on. Go ahead, sir.
It wouldn't be. And some of us right now are in that not yet because we refuse to hear what it is that he's telling us to do. But you have to listen. I heard the preacher say, you got to listen the second time. You got to listen the second time because what he said the first time might change. Do we need scripture? Y'all know what it is? We need scripture on that. I give you scripture for that. Scripture is when God told Abraham to go. All right, I want you to sacrifice Abram, your son. I want you to sacrifice Isaac. To sacrifice. First thing he heard was to take Isaac. Sacrifice.
Jesus.
Second time God spoke.
Come on.
Wait, there's a ram. Don't hurt the lad.
Mm-hmm.
But if we never keep our ears open to what God is saying, because God is constantly speaking.
Yeah.
He's constantly speaking. And a lot of times you'll think it's just you.
Right.
A lot of times He'll speak in your conscience.
Mm.
And say, oh, that's just me. That's just a thought.
Come on, sir. Help me.
That's just me.
Mm-hmm.
In there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know about it. And then we hesitate.
That's it.
And we kill what shouldn't have been killed.
Come on.
goodness. My goodness.
We did not hear.
Yep.
The second time.
Yep. That's
why
so good.
Why are you waiting? I believe God is preparing your spiritual ears to hear him in this second season.
You are saying
amen.
Something,
amen. Amen.
That's so good. That's so good.
Hallelujah, God. I thank you. He's preparing you
Jesus.
To hear what he has to say in this season.
Right now. Right now.
Season is over. That season that you were dealing with, that you were going through, that season of frustration and abandonment, that season of depression, that season of I'm not, it's over with now. God says, speaking to you.
Jesus.
Come on.
Do you hear the call?
Bridegroom
is coming.
Jesus.
What are you going to do while he's on his way? They hurried up and got up and prepared themselves. They put the oil in the lamp, and now they don't have any. And they told them, no, you can't have none. Go buy it for yourself. This thing costs. Preparation for what?
If it does, you have to be willing. That's right. That's good. That's good.
So you be willing and obedient.
That's it.
A lot of people are willing, but not obedient. When you be willing and obedient, when you hearken to the knock that he's knocking at your heart, and he knocks on every one of our hearts every day.
He does.
The day you wake up and say, I got to read the word. Jesus knocking at your heart. Read your word.
Yeah.
Every day you roll over out the bed and say, I got to pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It's Jesus knocking at your heart. He's constantly knocking. He's constantly speaking. He's telling them, he says, when they get back to the place to where they missed the move.
Jesus.
And they get back to that place where they missed it the last time.
Jesus.
It's okay that they missed it. They were sadly mistaken. What am I saying? God is saying we, as the children of God, as a people of God, cannot afford to miss him in this season.
Jesus.
We cannot afford to play church any longer.
Yeah.
We cannot afford to act like our relationship with him is on this level when it's not.
That's it.
We can't afford to miss the move that he's doing throughout the land. Can I tell you, he's raising up a new leader, raising up newness. This is a new thing that he's doing. He prophesied and said in the last days, sons and daughters prophesy. He says, I'm going to pour out my spirit upon what? All flesh. The very ones who think that you don't deserve it. Let me look dead into the camera. The very ones that think that you was too bad, that you blew it. God says, no. You're the one that I want to pour out my spirit on.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You're the one. I will raise up in this season.
Amen.
Because although your life was not perfect, you still had enough sense to wait on me.
Jesus.
You still had enough sense to prepare your heart and life. See, a lot of us know that he's coming back. A lot of us know that God is real. So there's only certain things that you will do. You won't go but so far. because you know he's real.
Mm-hmm.
He says, time out for that.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? He says, time out for that.
Yeah.
It's time out for it because I'm soon to return.
Mm-hmm.
I'm soon to come back. And you have to be ready. I have to be ready. And I can't be ready if I'm worrying about, it's going to sound harsh, if I'm worrying about somebody who was with me, who refused to prepare like I prepared.
Huh. That's it. He's saying something. Mm-hmm.
Yes, we go out there. We get you. We're praying for you. We're pulling you in.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll keep doing it. I'll keep doing it until God says stop.
Oh, my God.
He said there's some you have to let burn. You have to let do what it do. Mm-hmm. That's what Jesus said. If any branch in that is not connected to me, he says, shall be cast into the fire.
Jesus.
Because a broken branch can't produce.
Oh, man.
Hmm. Mm. A branch that has been broken off of the tree cannot be produced.
Mm.
But the miracle about God is that what other people see is broken. We talked about this. The stump still has life.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There's some trees that can break, and you can take that same limb and put it back in soil, and roots grow out of that. Some of us are in that place to where we've been broken. We've been disconnected. We haven't been doing it the way that we know that we ought to. But God says it's not too late.
Thank you, God.
I'm on my way. It's a warning.
Yeah. Oh. Yes.
He's soon to come.
Mm-hmm.
It's extra time to get it right.
Mm-hmm.
So
regardless of where you are in your walk with God, regardless to where you are in this particular time in your life, let's try and let's put up in our spirits and in our lives, and let's make a decision today. And say, God, I'm going to serve you
mm-hmm.
with everything that I have.
Come on.
I'm going to love on you with everything that I have because I want to be ready.
Mm.
I want to be ready for when you come back.
It's okay. Yes, God.
So let's pray. If that might be you, help us. Help us, Father, to serve you in the way, God, that is pleasing to you. Help us to have our lamps trimmed and burning. God, not just that. Help us to have vessels filled with oil that we can continue in our walk with you.
Yes, sir.
I pray, God, for those that are listening, those who are saved, those who are prepared for you. I pray, God, for their strength in these evil days that we're living in, where people don't respect your temple, your house, your physical house, where they come in and rob and kill in the house of God. Pray now, God, for the strength of your people.
Yes, sir.
God, for the remnant that still stand. Pray, God, that you will strengthen them with the strength that comes from you. God, when they're weak, God, give them strength.
Yes, God.
When they feel like they can't make it, God, give them strength.
Yes, God.
Pray, God, that you open their eyes, open their hearts to what it is that you have for them to do in this life. Show them their gifts. Show them their talents. So that it can be an access to the kingdom of you. Help us.
Bless
in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
to not be the one unprepared. But help us, God, to continue to be all that you have called us to be.
Yes.
We thank you now.
Thank you, God.
Be the light, God, in this dark world that we're living in. Help us to live it out. Purity, God. In our conversations, let our light shine. God, when we're in the grocery store, God, let our light shine, God.
Yes, God.
And how we spend our money, God, let, God Almighty, let our light shine. Because the earth is the Lord's, it is yours. All they that dwell therein, it belongs to you, God.
Mm-hmm.
You are the one who owns the cattle on the thousand hills. It's you who made the earth your footstool. It's you who spoke everything into existence. It's you, God.
Yes, God.
The creator, the almighty God, that the great I am, the I am, yes, that God. I am, the risen king. That it is you, God.
Yes.
That we serve, God. It's you that we bow down and worship, God. It's you.
Yes, oh, God. It's you.
Oh, God, it's you.
It's you.
It's not about us, God. It's not about what we have to offer. But it's about the talents, the gifts that you've given to us, God, that we can edify the body. Help us. Help us. In Jesus' name.
Thanks, God.
Amen.
Amen.
God of our soul. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Well, we love you on tonight. Pray that everyone had a received the word and had a good one on tonight. Amen. God is good. Listen, regardless to what it is that we think or that the enemy tries to come at you with, know that God loves you. Know that he has called you for a purpose at a time such as this. Know that. Know that he calls you to evangelize. He told you to walk into it. Know that he told that he anointed your witness and your testimony. Know this. So be a witness. Be a witness to somebody else. Be a witness to everybody. It's just that one. You never know the one. The one person that you might witness to, the one person that you might show love to, might be that one who can switch the whole direction of your life. You never know. You never know. You never know when you are entertaining angels.
Oh, yeah.
You never know. You never know. So do everything that you do with the mindset that I'm going to do it as if he's coming tomorrow.
Yeah.
I'm going to live my life as if he's coming tomorrow. Because we don't know. We just don't know. God bless you. We love you. We pray that everybody had a good one. Until next time, we'll see you. Thank you all for joining us.